As we explore quantum body, quantum reality, quantum mind, quantum universe, and more, as we explore these, the question comes up, is fundamental reality without boundaries? And are all boundaries conceptual and perceptual? So I once did I once edited a book where I asked approximately 100 physicists if they agreed on anything, because you know physicists, although they agree on the philosophy, or rather the recipe, the mathematical recipe of quantum mechanics, they do not agree on the philosophical implications. As you know, there are about 35 different interpretations of quantum mechanics, and everyone disagrees with each other. The two most accepted are currently Copenhagen, which brings in the observer into quantum mechanics, and then the multiverse theory, of course, conceived in consciousness, that's settles to the wave function branching off into infinite universes, multiverses. So that's where we are currently. But going back to our question, are all boundaries conceptual, perceptual, and is fundamental reality without boundaries? That was the one thing, by the way, that all physicists that I spoke to agreed about. No matter what they thought about the interpretations of quantum mechanics, whatever the differences were, they all agreed that fundamental reality is without boundaries. Let's explore this a little bit and see why it is important to understand this, to address fundamental questions about life, about birth, about death, and so on. So first of all, what is a boundary? A boundary, as usually defined, is a line or edge that separates two things. Boundary between my clothes and my flesh, for example. It can be physical, such as the border between two countries, which is totally conceptual and made up. Or it can be conceptual, as the boundary between the self and others. So you can see just by what I've said that boundary is something we make up. What is conceptual? Conceptual refers to something that is formed or constructed in the mind. It is not directly observable, but it is nonetheless real. For example, the concept of love is conceptual. We cannot see, touch, or hear love, but we can nonetheless experience it. Correct? Now go a little deeper and ask yourself, what is perceptual? Perceptual refers to something that is directly observed through the senses. It is something that we can touch, see, hear, taste, smell, etc. For example, the color red is perceptual, even though it's actually a qualia, fluctuation of consciousness, which is non-perceptual. In any case, we generally agree that we can observe the color red with our eyes. So are all boundaries conceptual or perceptual? Well, this is a very difficult question to answer, because if you ask the experts, they'll say probably yes, and it is important therefore to address it from many perspectives. Okay, this answer, the question is answered through many perspectives, and you know, you and I are not the first people thinking about this. For thousands of years, philosophers, scientists, mystics have pondered this question. From a philosophical standpoint, the concept of a formless and boundaryless reality is often associated with the unconditioned or the noumena, which gives rise to phenomena, perceptual and conceptual. So in philosophy, the boundaryless is the realm of pure being beyond the limitations of time, space, and causality. It is often described as an infinite and unchanging reality that is the source of all existence. And some philosophers, such as the German idealist Wilhelm Hegel, have argued that the unconditioned is ultimately unknowable to the human mind, because our minds are limited by our senses and our understanding of language, which are grounded in the world of forms and boundaries. Of course, Adi Shankara, the quintessential Indian mystic philosopher, argued that the unconditioned can be experienced through direct intuition, through mystical insight, and through meditation by transcending the senses. This is a state of consciousness that transcends the limitations of the mind and allows us to perceive reality directly. What about scientists? This has been addressed by modern physics, which has revealed that the universe is not made up of solid objects, but rather of fields and waves. These fields and waves are not bound by the same limitations as physical objects, and they can exist in multiple places at the same time. This idea led physicists such as David Bohm to propose that the universe is fundamentally holographic. This means that the entire universe is encoded in much smaller space, and that the boundaries between objects are an illusion. And then there's a very modern day physicist, Leonard Susskind, who recently got the Nobel Prize. And Susskind proposed that the universe is fundamentally digital. This means that the universe is made up of bits of information, on and off bits of information, and that these bits of information are what gives rise to the experience of the physical world. In other words, essentially, fundamental existence is without boundaries, but it vibrates digitally as fluctuations. And these fluctuations, as kind calls, information that gives rise to the appearance of the physical universe. Information, very interesting word, to give rise to form. What about mystical perspectives? And from a mystical perspective, the formless and boundaryless reality is frequently associated with the experience of higher states of consciousness, which I've described previously, but I will describe again in the near future in more detail. These states of consciousness are characterized by a state of unity, inseparability, and oneness with all things. And mystics from all cultures and traditions have reported experience of this kind. They often describe these experiences as a sense of being dissolved into the universe, or as a feeling of pure consciousness without form or boundaries. Okay, so that's basically how the boundaryless has been addressed philosophically, scientifically, through religious and mystical experiences, and on and on. Why even think about this? Or why do we question the idea that only that which has form is real?